after today's Supreme Court hearing, we are deeply disheartened and aggrieved. We observe that there has been no progress in the investigation of the horrific rape and murder of Abhaya, which was taken over by the CBI. From High Court to Supreme Court and from Kolkata Police to CBI, the investigation has been handed around, yet justice remained distant. Moreover, we saw that the state government and its lawyer, Kapil Sibal, playing a disgraceful role in trying to stop and malign our movement by any means. They claim that due to the junior doctors' strike, people are dying and patient services are being disrupted. We want to remind everyone clearly that the patient services are operational in every medical colleges in the state, with senior doctors tirelessly providing care. We also want to remind the public that there are 245 government hospitals in the state, out of which only 26 are medical colleges. The number of junior doctors is less than 7,500. West Bengal has nearly 93,000 registered doctors. Given that only a few medical colleges have junior doctors on strike, how can the entire healthcare system be said to be collapsing? This indicates that the government is spreading falsehoods and misleading the Supreme Court. We believe that this is a nefarious government effort to tarnish our movement and mislead the massive public support for it. We condemn Kapil Sibal and the health department, including the health minister, for this vile attempt to mislead the Supreme Court. We want to remind both the government and the Supreme Court that junior doctors are not the main pillar of healthcare system. They are merely trainees. If we accept the government's statistics as true, and then if the healthcare system collapses due to the junior doctors' strike alone, it actually highlights the serious shortage of senior doctors, nurses and healthcare infrastructure in government hospitals. The health department and health minister cannot escape responsibility for this. We also saw that Kapil Sibal and state government have shifted the blame for the violent activities that occurred during a political program on August 27 onto us. We want to remind clearly that we had stated on August 26 that we had no connection with the political program, did not support any violent or politically motivated activities, and will not do so in future. However, the way the government and their lawyer have lied to the Supreme Court, we strongly oppose and condemn it. Even after 30 days of the incident, the state government has not taken any sincere steps regarding the main demands of the movement. They are trying to place all the blame on the CBI investigation. No action has been taken regarding the police negligence or the healthcare corruption. The suspension of Shundeep Ghosh, Virupakha Bishwas or Obhik Dey seems more like a mere cover-up. In reality, Shundeep Ghosh was given only a nominal show cause notice after CBI arrest. The reasons for suspension of Obhik Dey and Virupakha Bishwas have not been mentioned. Such big suspension orders will be challenged and taken down in court. This appears to be nothing more than a facade to pacify public anger. We demand that strict disciplinary action be taken against Shundeep Ghosh and the health department suspend Obhik Dey and Virupakha Bishwas with proper justification. From the first day of movement, we have raised demands concerning safety. We have requested separate restrooms and bathrooms for on-duty doctors, adequate security personnel, CCTV and female security personnel for women, doctors' restroom and proper security measures outside wards and OT rooms. However, we want to demand that merely increasing police presence and separating doctors' rooms will not ensure safety. Ensuring proper patient services in government hospitals is essential to guarantee the safety of doctors and healthcare workers. The extensive corruption within the health system is present at all levels. There are numerous vacancies in the health system and in peripheral medical colleges are in a devastating state without advanced infrastructures or staff appointments. The healthcare system does not solely run on doctors, it also involves GDAs, technicians, nurses and doctors, all of whom are integral. Long-term permanent appointments are not being made for GDAs or technicians. Temporary workers are being hired instead, causing various problems. In our daily experience, we know that there is no proper referral system in the state's health system. There is no central referring system, no initiative to digitize the medical services in colleges, no facility managers listening to patient issues. Patients face harassment daily due to the lack of a proper referral system, and the government provides no information on how many patients die without treatment on a day-to-day basis. With super specialty hospitals and numerous medical colleges opening up, the situation in the workplaces remain unchanged. There is shortage of doctors, permanent nurses and healthcare workers. Most new medical colleges in the districts have minimal senior faculty and inadequate modern diagnostic facilities. We want to remind that building grand structures alone does not ensure healthcare services.
a sound health policy, proper staff appointments, and genuine government intent are required. Unfortunately, we do not see such a picture. We question why a seriously injured man had to travel 30 kilometers from Kondagam to Kolkata for a CT scan. And why was there no minimal CT scan facility in a nearby super specialty hospital? If the government genuinely cares about providing medical services to the poor people in district, why are district hospitals and primary healthcare systems not being revamped? We demand proper government.